This call is now being recorded.
Yes, sir.
The Sound of Music. Eveline Glennie listens to the sound without hearing it. So, when we read the title of the chapter, we get confused, right? How can someone listen to the sound of music without listening it, without hearing it? Or not? The title itself is very interesting. Author says that Eveline Glennie listens to sound without hearing it. Now we all wonder, we are confused. How can you listen to sound when you can't hear, when you are deaf? How can you listen to the sound? So this is something we will discover, that how Eveline Glennie was able to listen to sound although she could not hear, although she was deaf. Understood?
Yes, sir.
So before you read, what is given over here? God may have taken her hearing, but He has given her back something extraordinary. What we hear, she feels far more deeply than any of us. That is why she expresses music so beautifully. So someone has commented this about Eveline. He says, जिसने भी ये comment की है, he says that although God took away her hearing power, although God gave her deafness, she was impaired, means she was deaf, but God gave her an extraordinary thing, and that was the sense of feeling. She could feel very deeply, far more deeply than the normal people, than any of us. So do you all also agree that those who are deaf, they can feel better than us? The sixth sense is far more better than all of us. And that is why she was able to express music so beautifully, so well. She is a well-known multi-percussionist. She plays different percussions, different instruments like xylophone, drums. Have you seen these instruments?
Yeah, sir.
What?
What do you ask?
That she is a well-known multi-percussionist. She plays different percussion instrument like xylophone, drums. Have you seen these instruments?
Sir, I had seen drums, but not that second one.
Xylophone.
Yes.
Okay, we'll see. And in this lesson, we will learn that how she fought against a physical disability. What was the physical disability that she had?
He could not hear.
She?
Yes, sir. She could not
hear. What's her name?
Her name is Eveline Glennie.
Eveline Glennie.
Yes, sir.
And this is the real story. Very interesting it is. So, who will read paragraph 1?
Sir, can I read?
Okay, but don't go away in between.
Okay.
Even if you are doing something, keep answering. And others, be ready. I will tell anyone to switch on the camera for 1 minute in between. Just to know what you are doing. Randomly, anyone.
Okay, sir.
Okay, continue.
Rush or crowds jostle for position on the underground train platform. A slight girl looking younger than her 17 years was nervous yet excited as she felt the vibrations of the approaching train. It was her first day at the prestigious Royal Academy of Music in London, and daunting enough for any teenager fresh from a Scottish farm. But this aspiring musician faced a bigger challenge than most. She was profoundly deaf.
Okay. So what is given over here? See the first four lines. This is the scene of the train platform. Just imagine the scene of the train platform. It is underground. Platform underground. And there is a huge rush at the platform. People are pushing each other to get away. There is a small, thin girl. It is Eveline. Can you imagine this?
Yes,
Eveline, Eveline is standing at the railway platform waiting for the train. And just as she feels the vibrations of the approaching train, she realizes that the train is about to come. Means, see, she can see that, but she cannot hear. But the vibrations can be felt. You know, platform sometimes will shake. So she could hear, she could feel the vibrations that the train is approaching. Then she realizes that the train is about to come. She gets nervous and she's excited, both the feelings. Why? Because this train, this is the train that will take Eveline to London. She is going to London to learn music as she has got admission. Where has she got admission? Please tell me.
In London.
But where in London?
Royal Academy of Music.
Yes. Remember this name, it will come in question answers. Okay, so sir. She has got admission in the Royal Academy of Music. Right now, where is Eveline? Right now, she is in Scotland. You know where is it? Scotland. Eveline belongs to Scotland. She is Scottish, and Scotland is a country in Europe.
Yes, sir.
And if you know Scotland and London, what is the difference? I'll tell you, just for your knowledge. Life in Scotland is not as fast as in London, because London has very fast life. It is urban. Yes. Whereas Scotland has farms like khet and countryside, village type little bit. So Scotland has not that much fast life as in London. So that is why Eveline is nervous, because she is leaving Scotland for London. And she is excited also, because she is doing something that she always dreamt of. It was a dream to study, to learn the music in Royal Academy of Music. And it was her first day at the prestigious Royal Academy of Music. And it was daunting. See the word daunting. Can you see where is that word?
Frightening.
Yes, means because she was a teen, a teenager, just like you are a teen. So how old was she?
17 years.
Yes, so she was a teen. And she was from Scottish farm. Why Scottish farm? Because as I told you, in Scotland, there are a lot of farms. Farmers are there and farms are also there. So she belongs to Scotland from Scottish farm. And so she's nervous. She's a teen after all, a fresher.
Yes, sir.
And aspiring musician. She's aspiring musician. Aspiring musician means a person who wants to be a musician. Jisko musician banna hai. It's a dream. Profoundly deaf means what? Absolutely deaf. She cannot hear anything at all. So Eveline could not hear. And this was a bigger challenge for her. That if she cannot hear, how will she learn music? Is it possible?
Awesome.
Moving from a rural to a fast life was a smaller challenge. That she is going from Scotland to London. Okay, that was also a challenge. But this was a bigger challenge, that being deaf and learning music, it is next to impossible for people like us. But we should take inspiration from her that she did it. And today, yes, her name is there in our textbook. So Eveline faced a much bigger challenge, that was her inability to hear. Eveline's loss of hearing had been gradual. Means, you know, at first, from birth, she was not totally deaf. Do you know that? She was not born deaf. She lost her hearing gradually, means slowly, over the years. Her hearing, first it became 60%, then 20, like that, means she lost her hearing, not immediately at birth. Any doubt?
No, sir.
Okay, continue.
Eveline.
Okay, one second. Sorry. Is there anyone else who wants to read? Anyone? I would be happy if you take initiative. If you have no internet connection problem, then please read.
Yes, sir.
Read.
Eveline Granny's loss of hearing had been gradual. Her mother remembers noticing something was wrong when the 8-year-old Evelyn was waiting to play the piano. They called her name and she did not move. I suddenly realized she had not heard, says Isabel Granny, for quite a while, Evelyn managed to conceal her growing deafness from friends and teachers. But by the time she was 11, her marks and deteriorated. What's that?
Deteriorated.
And her headmistress
Are you reading? Hello.
I think he has no problem.
Yes. So no problem. I'll explain. Headmistress urged her parents to take her to a specialist. Did he read till there?
Sir, can I read once more from first?
Okay, sir. Read it, but be quick.
Okay, sir.
Sir, can I read?
Evelyn Glennie's loss of hearing had been
sorry, one second. Who asked me?
Moinuddin,
after this, the third paragraph I'll give you for reading.
Okay, sir.
Evelyn Glennie's loss of hearing had been gradual. Her mother remembers noticing something was wrong when the 8-year-old Evelyn was waiting to play the piano. They called her name and she did not move. I suddenly realized she had not heard, says Isabel Glennie. For quite a while, Evelyn managed to conceal her growing deafness from friends and teachers. But by the time she was 11, her marks had deteriorated and her headmistress urged her parents to take her to a specialist. It was
headmistress.
It was then discovered that her hearing was severely impaired as a result of gradual nerve damage. They were advised that she should be fitted. Yes, sir.
Severely.
Okay, sir. Hearing was severely impaired as a result of gradual nerve damage. They were advised that she should be fitted with hearing aids and sent to the school for the deaf. Everything suddenly looked black, says Evelyn. Okay. Sir, this is that cyclophone.
Not cyclophone. So? Xylophone.
Ah, yes, xylophone.
Yes.
Sir, I had played this.
A musical. My voice is reaching late, right?
No, sir. It is coming.
Actually, yes, it is there, but only it is reaching late because of internet connection problem.
Okay.
One second, I'll present. Yes, so now you know what is xylophone.
Yes, sir.
Like a row of wooden bars, different lengths. So now, what is given in the second paragraph? Slowly, she started losing the power of hearing, and one day she was absolutely deaf. Isabel Glennie is the name of Evelyn's mother.
Yes, sir.
And Evelyn's mother, Isabel, remembers one incident. What was that? When Evelyn was 8 years old, she says that Evelyn was waiting for her turn to play the piano. Means maybe all the children were waiting for their turns. So she was also waiting for her turn. But when her name was called out, she did not respond. Like when I call out Mohammed, you will say yes.
Yes.
So, like in the class, if I call out anyone's name, but she did not respond at that time when she was 8 years old. And her mother realized that Eveline did not respond to her name. That means she did not hear her name being called out. So that was the first time when the mother realized that something is wrong with her ears. So for quite a while, Eveline managed to conceal. Conceal means hide. Eveline was able to hide her deafness from the friends and teachers till when she was 10 years old. Why? Because she was not completely deaf at that time. Conceal means to hide. Then here it is given deteriorated. Deteriorated means worsened, reduce. Okay?
Yes.
Urged means requested. So what happened? When Eveline was 11 years old, her marks started reducing. The headmistress, the principal also requested the parents, please take Eveline to a doctor, to a specialist who can treat her. But it was discovered that her hearing was severely impaired, means totally deaf she had gone, as a result of gradual nerve damage. Uski jo ek nerve hoti hai, that means in the ears there are different nerves. Nerves kehwai na apne. So that was severely damaged. And after the checkup, what happened? The doctor advised Eveline's parents that they should get hearing aids for her. Hearing aids means what? Have you seen hearing aids?
Yes, sir.
What is it? Who is this?
Harsh.
Hearing aids is an equipment.
Means, it is a type of machine that we can hear someone yes. else that is telling to us.
Yes, correct.
Like it, so hearing is, aids, it is like that earphone.
Yes, it looks similar to that.
Yes, sir.
So hearing aids is an equipment that is fitted into your ear and it helps a person to hear to some extent. It does not give you the hearing power 100%, but it helps you somewhat. So the doctor also suggested her parents that Eveline should be sent to school for deaf children because she is a special child. And then what happened? When Eveline discovered that she could not hear and that she would be sent to a school for deaf children, that she was not as good as normal children, her world became colorless. Because she was a child, it turned black. Everything suddenly looked black, means that her world became colorless. It means that all of a sudden she got such a bad news. You know, you get some news that you don't expect, and in return you see blackness all around you. Disappointment, yes. Sadness. So that is how Eveline responded to this news. But do you think that she gave up?
No.
No. Eveline was not going to give up. We'll see that. Paragraph 3. Now, Mohinuddin, will you read?
Yes, sir. Number 3. But Eveline was not going to give up. She was determined to lead a normal life and pursue her interest in music. One day she noticed a girl playing a xylophone and decided that she wanted to play it too. Most of the teachers discouraged her, but percussionist Ron spotted her.
Percussionist Ron Forbes.
Ron Forbes spotted her potential. He began by turning two large drums to different notes. Don't listen through your ears, he would say. Try to sense it some other way, says Eveline. Suddenly I realized I could feel the higher drum from the Forbes. Repeated the experience and soon Evelyn discovered that she could sense certain notes in different parts of her body. I had learned to open my mind and body to sounds and vibrations. The rest was sheer determination and hard work.
Okay. So, Ron Forbes is actually Ronald Forbes. He's also of 74 years of age now. He is in United Kingdom. And he's an artist. Just to tell you, you're for your knowledge. Then what happened? What did Eveline do instead of giving up? Are you listening? Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
So this shows Eveline had determination. Although Eveline got such a shocking news, still she was determined and she did not want to give up. As Eveline was passionate about music, music was her passion. This news also did not break her that she is totally deaf. She was determined to live life like normal people and follow her interest in music. She thought herself that I am normal, nothing has happened to me. And that attitude helped her a lot. What happened? One day she noticed a girl playing a xylophone and at the same time she decided that she wanted to play it too. You know what is xylophone? It's an instrument like with a wooden row of wooden bars. So she also decided that she would also do it. So most of the teachers discouraged her. Means most of the teachers said that you cannot do it, you are deaf and all that things. But one man whose name is Ron Forbes, he was a percussionist, means he already played that instrument. Ron Forbes treated her in a different way. He saw the potential in this girl, that this girl is really capable of this thing. And
so your voice is cutting. Play music.
Can you play music without hearing?
So your voice is cutting.
What?
Your voice is cutting.
Okay. Sorry.
And yes, sir, your voice second. Was coming echo from your second ID.
Now is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Now is it clear?
Yes, sir, clear. Sir, the voice cutting started
so
from
Ron
end.
Forbes. Yes. So on one end, Eveline's teachers discouraged her because they knew that she could not hear.
Sir, your voice is echo. Coming with
but you are making that's why.
Tara
Mike
ne vajiti thais. Tara Mike ne vajiti thais.
So, please, on one end, Eveline's teachers discouraged her. Why? Because they knew that she could not hear, and hearing was an important part of music. But Ron Forbes saw Eveline and was very passionate about music. And so he decided something. What did he decide? Ron Forbes thought that he would teach Eveline to feel music. He took two large drums and turned them to different notes. So he took two large drums उसको डिफरेंट नोट्स में लाइक ही टर्न देम टू टू डिफरेंट नोट्स. हाउ यू प्ले द ड्रम्स एंड यू टर्न द नोट्स. सो ड्रम्स आर म्यूजिकल इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स एंड ही टर्न देम. He tuned each drum to different notes. So the sound produced by the drums were different. So one drum he played at a higher tune and one drum at a lower tune at the another one. So it was distinct. It was different. Both the drums made different sounds. Then he told Eveline, don't listen through your ears. Try to sense it some other way. Try to feel that vibration of the drums through your body, in your body. Don't try to hear because you are deaf, so just feel it. He said, don't try to listen to through your ears. He said, try to sense it. Try to feel the music some other way. So the middle of your body is called waist, right? You know, where we tie, a belt. So now, as Ron turned both the drums to different notes, the upper part of Eveline's body is above waist. Her body could feel the higher drum, the higher notes of the drum, and the lower part of her body below the waist, that part down from the waist could feel the lower notes of the drum. Means she was feeling that. Are you getting it?
Yes, sir.
Yes. So Forbes, Ron Forbes repeated this exercise, and soon Eveline discovered that she could sense, that she was able to sense this in the different parts of her body, that she is able to feel music. So Ron Forbes taught Eveline to respond to different sounds through different parts of the body. And that is how she could identify the sounds and different vibrations. Ron Forbes played a very big role in her life. Now once she could identify the sounds and vibrations, that obstacle, that problem that she had, she could easily overcome that. And Eveline's career went upward, as she had determination to become famous, a good musician, and she also did a lot of her hard work. She never looked back.
Yes.
Then we'll read the next.
So no one will read, then tell me, I will read.
Sir, can I continue?
We'll read.
Moinuddin.
Yes. Yes, yes, continue.
Number four. She never looked back from that point onward. She turned the United Kingdom with a youth orchestra, and by the time she was 16, she had declared to make music her life. She auditioned for the Royal Academy of Music and scored one of the highest marks in the history of the Academy. She gradually moved for orchestral work to solo performance. At the end of her 3-year course, she had captured most of the top awards.
Continue, five also.
And for all this, Eveline won't accept any hint of heroic achievement. If you work hard and know where you are going, you will get there. And she got right to the top, the world's most sought after multi-talented, with a mastery of some thousand instruments and hectic international schedule.
Complete. Am I audible?
Yes. Yes, sir.
Okay, did you read number five fully?
Yes, sir. I have read five also.
Okay. So, once Eveline overcame the hurdle, she solved this problem. She started sensing the different sounds through the different parts of her body. She progressed in her career. What did she do? Orchestra. Do you know what is orchestra? Can anyone tell me? What is orchestra? No one? Means you have not heard this word? It's a very common word.
Konsa, sir?
Where are you, Mohammed? Are you present physically, mentally?
Yes, sir, present.
Yes. Okay, because I called out this word 3 times.
Sir, I was reading ahead, so that's why.
So, what is the meaning of orchestra?
Sir, it's new word for me.
Sorry, what did someone say?
Sir, orchestra means a musical instrument.
It is orchestra, and it is the name for group of musicians. Any parties are organized and orchestra is called, even in functions. So here what happened, so Eveline toured the United Kingdom. She went on the tour to the UK and performed with youth orchestra, young people like who are in the college or high school. By that time, Eveline reached the age of 16 years. She had decided to make music her life. She decided that I will make music my life. And what happened, you know, she gave auditions. I hope you know what are auditions. Short performance is given for selection. Yes, so, Eveline gave an audition for the admission to the Royal Academy of Music, and her score was the highest in the history of the academy, being the deaf then also. No other person had scored such a high score as Eveline did. And then what happened? Initially, she performed in the group as she got well in her music. First, she was participating with the groups. But as she got confident, she started performing alone, solo performance.
Then, yes.
At the end of 3-year course, she had captured most of the top awards. She got so many awards at the end of the 3 years, finishing her course in the academy. She had achieved all the top awards by the 3-year course in the Royal Academy of Music. If anyone says that Eveline has done something great, she does not acknowledge that. She is very humble and down to earth. You know, when someone praises her, she does not accept it so easily. She is very down to earth, very humble. She does not boast about herself. And yes. Eveline says that 2 important things for success are, firstly is your hard work. Secondly is your aim. You must have an aim in your life. And second is hard work. She says that if you work hard and if you have an aim, a target which you have to achieve, then you will definitely achieve it. No one can stop you. And she, what does she say? Eveline also achieved her goal. She worked hard. She had an aim to become the topmost, the most famous, the most sought after musician. See here the word is given. The most sought after. Sought after means in demand. She wanted to become the musician who is in demand by everyone. She wanted to become famous. So she wanted, this was her aim, right? In the world, she wanted to become the most famous multi-percussionist. She has a very busy schedule today. And she gained mastery of almost 1,000 musical instruments. Just imagine, mastery over 1,000 musical instruments. She has programs and concerts all over the world. People from different countries invite her. It is intriguing to watch Eveline function so effortlessly without hearing. That without any efforts, it will come in the 6th paragraph, how easily she plays music without any efforts. Because she has mastery over 1,000 musical instruments. Do you understand, Tilia?
Yes, sir.
See this. What can you see? in this picture. It is intriguing. Intriguing means what? Fascinating. It is very curious. We are eager to watch Eveline. She is functioning so effortlessly, means so easily she is playing this instrument without hearing. How is it possible? Isn't it a kind of miracle? That a person who is deaf, she is performing so effortlessly. Right? Understood?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So we shall continue this. Okay? Right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Bye. Take care.
Bye.